It's your boy Malik, aka Spanko, and I'm here with
Lay Shifty, and this is What's Good at BHHS.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Did y'all know we had an esports team?
Peep game, check this out.
We got an esports player over here wanting to do an interview, so I'm gonna do that. First question, what is esports like to you?
It seems pretty fun to me and looks pretty cool. And I usually play half of the games that are here.
What game are you really good at out of all of them here?
Usually Rocket League. I play Rocket League like every day, mostly all day.
Have you been in any tournaments yet?
No, first year doing this.
I hope you have a lot of fun. Question.
Yeah.
Yes. So what's esports like for you?
Fun. We get to play video games in school.
What tournaments do you plan to join?
I plan to do Smash Bros, Pokemon Unite, what are the other games? Mario Kart, pretty much everything besides 2K.
Alright, I see. How do you get into esports exactly?
You would talk to lovely Miss Reese right here, and you would ask her in the time period that she gave us if you want to join esports. But pretty much, if you like playing games, it's perfect for you.
Do you have anything to say about esports, Miss Reese?
Esports is competitive video game play. We have 48 people on our team. Andrew Street is also starting a team this year. They have 3 people on their team, and we are going to compete with them this year, which is going to be really cool.
Up next, we got a special career segment.
Take it away, Renaya and Mike.
Hello, my name is Renaya.
And I'm Mike, and this is Careers in Broadcasting. So today we're going to be talking to Ms. Dunn. Ms. Dunn, can you tell us about yourself?
My name is Jordan Dunn. I'm the Director of Membership at Pittsburgh Community Broadcasting, which is home to 90.5 WESA, a local news NPR station, and 91.3 WYEP, which is a local music station. As the Director of Membership, I oversee revenue that's coming into our organization through fundraising. And you probably also know that I am married to Mr. Tagmar.
Okay, so I'll be asking you your first question. Who helped you on the way to success?
First, my parents did. They always pushed me to get good grades, to participate in sports, to always, you know, try my best. Mr. Tagmar also supports me in anything that I want to do, any crazy ideas I might have, or just things I want to try. And also a lot of professors and teachers along the way. They always gave me great feedback, whether it's on papers, tests, and whatnot, and so they really helped me to get where I am today.
What was your biggest inspiration, and when did it start?
From a really young age, I was very, very competitive. I absolutely loved sports and took an interest in women's sports in particular, and so it was something that I studied all through undergrad into graduate school. I also always wanted to give back to the community, so I've always been very involved with any nonprofits. I am also on the board for Girls on the Run, which is a great local organization that works with elementary level kids. My personal biggest inspiration from whenever I was very young is a professional soccer player named Mia Hamm. I just absolutely adored her as a kid, and I feel like she really inspired me to go and chase all of my dreams.
If you had your own station, what would it be called and why?
Like I kind of mentioned in answers before, I'm a very competitive person. I really like being in charge. I really like calling the shots. So if I had a station, I would call it Boss FM, B-O-S-S FM, and we would just play really good music.
Ms. Dunn, thank you for your time.
And always, thanks for watching.
Yo, let's see what's cracking on what's popping in Braddock Hills.
It's popping. It's popping. It's popping. It's popping.
What's up, Braddock Hills?
It's your girl, Destiny.
It's your girl, Tyrea.
And today, we're here to talk about what's popping at BHHS.
The Industrial Arts Workshop is coming to Braddock Hills after school. Learn valuable skills such as welding and metal fabrications while working on giant public art. This is a free program provided at BHHS. Classes will be after school starting in May-October and will meet twice a week. For more information, talk to Mr. Morgans and Ms. Le. Apply at www.imwpgh.org.
After school programs is popping off. Space may be limited. Sign up now.
California University of Pennsylvania will visit BHHS on October 5th at 8:30 a.m. Sign up using the Google form. If you have any questions, see Ms. Gray.
The music production class has been working with a national organization called Notes for Notes. Scholars are learning all about the music industry, recording, and composing their own beats, loops, and songs.
Do you have anything that's popping?
If so, contact Mr. Morgan for more information, and it will be on next week of What's Popping at BHHS. Bye!
Yo, let's see what's...
Hey, take three.
Get out.
It's
cracking. hey, BHMS. Hey, thanks for watching. See you next episode.
Like, comment, subscribe.